Alright, number one. Okay, first absolute. Attend fast start training with your group within 24 hours. Here's the thing. We're pretty much doing those trainings, guys, after every single event, we do a fast start training. But you, who's been to fast start training? Pretty much everybody, exactly. Here's the thing, guys. If you sign somebody up, let's say tomorrow, you don't wait till the next training. You don't wait till Tuesday. You don't wait till the next training to get them trained. You train that person immediately. That's why we got the fast start training. Right now, we're already creating the fast start training booklet. So the fast start training, we're going to have it in a booklet. How to launch your business, how to go founder 3 in a booklet. So you're literally going to be able to, who can point and read? Raise your hand. Everybody, exactly. I know it's a silly question. If you can point and read, you can train somebody. These are the tools that we're coming out with, guys. It's only going to get better and easier. Trust me. And then when it gets better and easier, we got more tools, better systems, and all of you guys are going to be better trained, and there's going to be more success stories. You imagine what's going to happen? That's when the exponential growth is going to happen. But you got to get it done within the first 24 hours. You got to have sense of urgency. You got to have a sense of urgency. Live portal with the fast start booklet. Also, duplicate this training with every single one of your new partners. You sign somebody up, get them the fast start training, get them to put you in front of their people, following the system. Get them signed up, get them trained immediately. That's crucial. Number two, attend every event, trainings, conference calls. Obviously, the live presentation. Super Saturdays. Okay, 2 to 3 events per week if you are part-time. 4 to 10, hold up. 2 to 3 events per week and 4 to 10 three-way calls per week. That's very doable. So 2 to 3 events. So for instance, we've got the Monday night. Can we agree?
Yeah.
Monday night is the most packed meeting. Awesome. You guys are doing a phenomenal job. And you're going to get a lot of new people getting started. If you don't create that duplication in depth with your group, which a lot of you guys are, some of you guys, we got to work on that. That's why you're in training. You've got to get 5 to 7 levels deep fast. If you got just your group coming, a couple of guys that you recruited yourself coming, and it hasn't duplicated past that, you're doing something wrong. We gotta keep following the system, and you gotta be more consistent. So 2 to 3 events per week, and 4 to 10 three-way calls per week. That's if you are part-time. Get everyone on your team to be the best every single week. And this is, guys, by the way, a 52-week commitment. You follow this system for the next 52 weeks. The 7 absolutes. You follow it for the next 52 weeks. Four to six presentations per week if you're part-time. That, guys, is at a Starbucks, at somebody's home. That is very doable. Think about it. If every presentation takes you, and guys, these presentations are fast. Do a one-on-one with somebody, it's fast. It takes about 30 minutes. Let's say those presentations takes you an hour. That's 4 to 6 hours a week that you're doing outside of the presentation that you're building. 4 to 6 a week. Who can say that they're doing on average 4 to 6 presentations a week outside of these meetings? Raise your hand if you do 4 to 6 a week. Online presentations count. Okay. Not nearly enough people. So when you start realizing, okay, I'm not getting the results that I want, that's why. Guys, 4 to 6 presentations a week is an extra 4 to 6 hours a week. Who has 4 to 6 hours a week to dedicate to their business? Of course. Some people are going to go through this. They're going to go a year. They're going to still be not at the rank that they want. Then they're going to realize, you know what, man? I'm going to just start doing the damn system. Then you're going to do the damn system, and you're going to see some crazy growth. You're going to realize, damn, I lost a year. I was so silly for not following the damn system. They said it at trainings all the time, and I was like, yeah. And I would do 20%, 50%. Dude, who wants to be in the same place that they're at right now in a year? Of course not. A year's going to come pass by anyways. I'm just telling you guys this because time will either promote you or expose you in this business. It's either going to promote you or promote you. Guys, there's already people, I see it, that don't show up to trainings or events because we recognize people because guess what? They still haven't done what they said they were going to do. Or they're not where they think they should be by now. And guess whose fault that is?
Their
fault. It's our fault. A champion takes 100% responsibility for everything, good or bad, that happens to them. A victim justifies, complains, and blames. A victim justifies, complains, and blames. Blames other people, blames a system, blames a company. They find a reason. Oh, but this. And then they blame somebody else. No, it's just my upline isn't helping me. Dude, you got a system. Plug into the system. Let's say your upline quits. Are you going to quit?
No.
Some people, oh, well, my upline quit. I always like to use stories. And this is a story that relates to this. And it helped me out a lot when I heard it. There's these two guys, these two twins. And these guys, these twins, are identical twins. And their father was just a really poor example of a father. And this guy says, the father was an alcoholic. He used to smoke. He used to drink. He used to beat on their mom. Just a terrible example. One boy grows up to be just like his father. The other boy grows up to be the opposite. He's a good man. You know what I mean? Doesn't do all of those things that his father did. He's successful. He's not a deadbeat. Those two boys get interviewed. Hey. And they're asked one question, a lot of questions, but one of them is exactly the same question. Like, how did you end up the way that you are? And then the kid that ended up just like his dad says, well, my dad was a womanizer. He was a drunk. He was this and that. He was a loser. He used to beat my mom. What did you expect? I ended up like my dad. The other kid, they asked him the same question. He says, well, my dad was a drunk, a womanizer. He used to beat on my mom. He was an alcoholic. He used to use drugs. He was a deadbeat. I didn't want to be like my dad. One of them used it as fuel and a reason. The other one uses it as an excuse, as a victim. In a year from now, we're all going to be someplace. And where we're at is exactly where we're going to deserve to be. 100%. Where we're at right now is thanks to us. We picked those cards. We made it happen. The decision that we made in the past got us. This year, simply, all it is we're just suggesting for you to make these decisions to have success. Because the people that do them have results, and the people that don't do them don't have results. That's all we can do. We can simply share this information with you. What you do with it is completely up to you. Somebody once told me, we have the freedom of choice, but we don't have the freedom of consequence. Is that true or what, guys?
Yeah.
Think about it. We can choose to do whatever we want. You could choose to go out there and drive super fast and run a red light. You got that freedom. But the consequences that come from that, it's different. Number four, two contacts a day. Guys, this is easy. Two contacts a day. Go out there and contact two people, whether people you know, people you don't know. Make two contacts a day. People that keep their income options open. Prospect two people per day. If the day runs out, if you haven't prospected two people today, go to a 7-Eleven. There's always two people working behind the counter at 7-Eleven. Go ahead, expose them. I'm not worried, guys, about the no's or the yeses. I'm worried about your activity. Too many people are focused on, you know, like the results. The results will come if you focus on the activity. You guys hear me say, been saying this for a long time. What is the activity? How many presentations? How many people are you exposing? You do that enough. You do enough activity that's productive, productive, right? The results are going to get there. 100% the results are going to get there. You just have to do that activity long enough. So two prospects a day, who could do that? Raise your hand if you could do two prospects a day. Now, who in this room really thinks that two prospects a day is hard? Raise your hand if you think that prospecting two people a day is hard. Is it easy?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's easy. Think about it. All it is easy. All it is getting outside of your comfort zone. Can we agree?
Yeah.
All it is going and opening your mouth. Just go up to somebody, man. Just open your mouth. Let's say you see this guy with the phone. Hey, when he's thirsty, you better say something. Right? You're like, hey, yes? Nice phone, bro. You know, then the first thing you mess it all up. All
right, cool.
Stop, stop. Do it again. Then you see the guy with the computer. Hey, he looks at you. Big computer, man. Right on. What'd you get?
Costco.
All right, Costco, here I go. You messed it up, right? Then eventually, you're gonna get tired of not prospecting. You say, hey, what's up,
going?
Man?
I'm going.
Yeah, that's a nice computer, man.
Thanks, appreciate it.
JC, by the way.
Oh,
Edgar. Good, man. You coming often?
Once in a while.
Once in a while? That's good, man. What do you do here at Chuck E. Cheese once in a while? Eat pizza?
Eat pizza, bring my nephews.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up, man. Me too, man. I'm just here, you know, just about to have some pizza.
Right on.
Listen, man, this might be a shot in the dark, but do you keep your income options open? You look like a sharp guy.
Yeah, I do.
Cool, man. Look, I got to run, but the company I'm working for is actually looking for some people.
Okay.
And what I can do is I'm not promising anything, but let me get your contact information.
Okay.
And, you know, I'll give you a call and we'll see what we can do. Is that fair?
Sounds good.
Cool. The first time you might suck. The first time you might say, no, thanks. Then after a while, you're like, damn, I'm getting pretty damn good. Then you're like, man, I will prospect 10 people a day. Because it gets, yeah, you can do a blindfold. You can do it backwards. You can do, you know what I mean? Whatever. You get to the point of unconscious competence. Then you're just like, bam, oh, man.
How would you do it for, like, the guy that's working at the gas station? What would you? Yeah. Like, say 7-Eleven, right?
Yeah.
Anyone can do it, but... What's like a good way?
Honestly, so I don't really have a script. You know what I mean? I got something to say, but like anything. Like, let's say this guy's working at, let's say Jonathan's working at the 7-Eleven, right? Hey, what's up, man? You know, I don't know how this goes up. Yeah, so, you know, I'm guessing, what do you think? It's a stingray. No, that's not duplicatable. Right? So let's keep it duplicatable. So I was gonna go with that one, but then I realized that everybody has a stingray, right? I have a Ferrari, so I can fly. So we're gonna keep it duplicatable. So like, let's say this guy works at the gas station. Let's say it's around this time. It's late, right? So I get, now it's late, right? I go, hey, you know, 50 on number 8. Cool. By the way, man, you look young. You know what I mean? How long have you been working here?
About 4 months.
Yeah? It's good. It's good. Well, listen, this might be weird. You know what I mean? I never met you, but I'm actually expanding my company in this area. I'm looking for a couple of young guys interested in 3 to 4 months. Do you know anybody that might be interested? I mean, you got a job, but probably not you. Do you know some people, some of your friends that maybe are looking for a job?
Definitely.
I'm looking for sharp people, though, man. I want to make some serious money. This is like, what I'm talking about is the low-end guys. You know what I'm saying? So do you have any sharp friends? Because, you know, I don't know that many people. You know, how old are you? Like 18?
Yeah, 18.
Okay. So I'm looking for you between like 18 and 21 years old. I don't know that. I'm 31, bro. So, you know, my friends were 18 a long time ago. See, you just strike a dead card in. See, my friend, like, that's my friend. Come on here. You know what I mean? That guy's not 18. Right? Like, anything, man. You know, I like, hey, this might be a shot in the dark, but do you keep hearing about your dope? Straight up, you know, you go to the guy. Hey, how's your day so far, man? You know, you about to get off or you just get in? Damn, you work the night shift. See, I'm just like finding common ground. Damn, you work the night shift, man. Do you like it or?
Kind of sucks.
Hey, at least it's not hot outside. You gotta give it that. You gotta look at the positive, man. That's good. That's good. So besides this, you go to school or what do you do?
Yeah, I go to school as well.
Good, but this pays the bills.
Yeah.
But listen, man, we're looking for some people that want to make an extra, you know, couple thousand bucks a month. Do you keep your income options open?
Definitely.
Yeah? Okay, cool. Look, I'm not promising anything. What I could do is I could give you a call tomorrow, and I'll see what I can do. You know, we're looking at expanding this area. You know, the whole down east, Southgate area. Depends where you're at. You know, you mentioned the city, right?
And let me get
you. Huh?
You said tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. But guess what? You don't have to be great to do it, but, you know, you just do it. You feel better than not doing it. You know what I mean? So then when I'm doing this, now, this is also cold market. So if I'm exposing somebody's face that's warm market, then I, you know, but yeah, you're right. We could use in the next 24 hours. So I'll give you a call tomorrow or in the next 24 hours, and, you know, we'll see what we can do. Not promising anything, but let me get your contact information. The thing is, just get out there and... get outside of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
Who cares? I literally have people tell me in the beginning, is this a little pyramid? And I was like, oh, damn. I have no idea what to answer. I got like red. I've had people laugh in front of me. I had my friend Ivan at a Starbucks. I was there. I was like sitting down. I had an appointment with him and he showed up. This guy will prospect people everywhere. This guy, I've never met somebody prospects people in cold market more than this guy. Like, it's crazy, man. He goes up there and he starts prospecting some guys and they're like, get out of here, blah, blah, blah. They got like mad at him.
But one thing about Ivan that he does is that he gets really close to people, like, you know, like uncomfortable close.
Yeah.
You know, to me, like, he comes like, he's like, hey, brother. Now, I like use my hand like this, like, let's see, he's in front of me. I'm like, well, you know, so you can't get that like that. Yeah, you know what I mean? So two contacts per day, guys, is easier to do. Problem is, it's easier not to do. That's the situation. That's your problem. And I do say problem intentionally. Because it is your problem. It's easier not to do. Number five. Personal development every single day. This is a form of personal development as well. But that says every day. Can we agree with that?
Yeah.
You know? It's not like, it's like showering. You're not just going to shower once a week or once a month. Can we agree?
Yeah.
You need that personal development every day. And here's the thing, though. If you're not doing it, your team's not going to do it. Okay. Thinking Pro Rich, The Science of Getting Rich, GoPro, all of these are great audios and great books that you can read. These are all things that I recommend. I recommend GoPro first to learn how to build your business, then the science of Getting Rich. A lot of people recommend Thinking Grow Rich first. I personally recommend The Science of Getting Rich first. I like it more, right? But Thinking Grow, you can't go wrong with any of these books, okay? Success is something you can track by the person you become, okay? These guys, you're never going to reach, let's say first you got somebody at a level 9, sharp in personal development, and you're at a level 2. It's going to be very hard for you to recruit that one guy. Unless you start growing. Now, there are ways to do it. Expose them the right way. Remember the whole field felt found?
Yeah.
The whole field felt found. Hey, listen, man. Well, you know, excuse me, not field felt found. Help, favor, and opinion. Hey, listen, I want to see if you can do me a favor. You know, I got started looking at, you know, I just looked at this business, and I'm very excited about it. Wanted to see if you could give me your opinion. I respect your opinion. Could you help me out? Right? Sure, kid, I'll help you out. They see the business. If they get started, they get started on your team. But it is so much easier, guys. But see, here's the thing. You're not going to attract those people. There's a difference. There's attracting, and there's going after. There's like in the training at the convention, they talk about three different hunters. You know what I mean? The second best hunter is the one, is like the lions. They're the ones that go. Does that make sense, guys? They're those that go after their prey. And the best hunter is a spider. Because they set the trap. And the people come to them. They attract the prey. You guys remember that? The ones that were there? Was that powerful or what?
Yeah.
That was a great training. Guess what? When you bump up your personal development, when people start to realize, man, there's a change in you. You're more confident. Your leadership is up. You know what I mean? Then you start having more success in your business. You start attracting a different caliber of people that will join your business when they otherwise would not join your business. There's going to be some people, man, that you're not going to see for a couple of months. They're going to be like, dude, you're different. You know what I mean? And then you start attracting these people, but you have to do the personal development, and that's done every single day. What are some books you gotta read? And guys, don't shout out books you cannot read, or just shout out, oh, I know Think and Grow Rich. I'm gonna say Think and Grow Rich. Out of Win Friends and Influence People, good. The Wolf Mentality.
Rich Dad Poor Dad.
Nice. Yeah, did that on purpose. You guys notice that? You see how I did that? What are the books?
I'll win the devil.
Rich Dad, Poor Dad.
I have not read that one, but it's good?
Yeah.
Okay. Any other books?
Bible.
The System Building?
Bible.
Nice. Okay, so personal development, guys. Number 6, attend and promote all big events. Versus next big event. We just had the big event, the corporate event. Next big event is the Super Saturday. You show up to these things. See, there's going to be some people, could be in this room, could be not, that are going to show up for like a year and not have any results. Guys, I've seen this happen so many times. And I bet you a bunch of the people that have been around MMR for a long time, see it. Where somebody just kept showing up. Had a little team, made a little bit of money. Then they go like this. Here's how it happens. Because of the personal growth, the experience, the contacts that they're making along the way. They're going like this for like a whole year. Then all of a sudden, the one-year mark, the person goes like, boom, it explodes. They're like following through the whole damn year. Or struggling to be following through the whole year, but they're being consistent. They're following the system. They're paying the price. Then before you know it, they start attracting people. A lot of people that they told them no in the beginning, like, hey, you still doing that wake up now thing? They're like, heck yeah, man. What else would I be doing? You know what I mean? Of course I am. With posture, they're like, damn. Last time, when he barely introduced me, he wasn't that confident. After a year, he must be doing pretty good. They don't know. You know what I mean? He's doing all right. I mean, you know, he's making some extra money. But they're like, hey, you know what, man? You know, and remember, every 3 months, something major happens in somebody's life. So recruiting is all about timing. You tell somebody today about an opportunity. They just got a promotion. They're probably not open. But 3 months from now, they got fired. Or 3 months from now, they realize it's not what all they thought it was going to be. Now they're open. Let's say you talk to somebody right now. You know, him and his girlfriend are cool. Then later on, his girlfriend dumped him. Because he was a loser. So then he's like, I don't want to be a loser. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden the guy's like, man, I need to be busy. I need to keep busy. I need to do something, blah, blah, blah. Then all of a sudden you recruit a boom. Then you start recruiting people. Then you start attracting people that you otherwise would not attract because of all the personal development, all those trainings, all those hours you dedicate to your crafting your business. Then before you know it, boom, you explode. And these people explode, not just in their personal development, their ranks. I'm talking about ranks. I've seen this happen like crazy. Some of you guys in 1 year, you can go out there, you can literally make $10,000 your ranks right now in 1 year. But most people won't stick it out. Most people will find excuses not to come to the next training or the next event. A lot of people will say, I don't got a guest tomorrow. Let's say Wednesday. I don't got a guest today. I'm not gonna make it. I went on Monday. I went to train. I won't make it. They don't have that faith in the process that we talk about. And they let little, then guess what? Every single little decision, error in judgment or discipline is attracted, brings a flock of its relatives. You know what I mean? But like, here's the deal, guys. If you attend on Monday and Tuesday, at least you're doing that. You're attending one opportunity, meaning you're attending one training. Awesome job. You want to take it, here's the thing. Don't, minimums or maximums? Don't do the minimum. Does that make sense? And your team, that's the minimum that you do is the maximum that your team will do. Does that make sense, guys? You will duplicate what you do. Don't be that guy. Guys, I said the story last time of Kobe Bryant, okay? And there's a lot of new people here, so I'm going to say it again. I don't like Kobe Bryant, but I respect his hustle, okay? This guy says that, you know, he was around Kobe Bryant, and he goes like at 3 in the morning to the gym. Kobe Bryant was there shooting, and he was already sweating, drenched in sweat. He's like, damn, he was there for like a couple hours. Leaves at around 5 in the morning. Gets back around 11 in the morning. He only slept a couple hours. Because he was like interviewing or shooting a video with these people, right? With these athletes. He gets up, goes around 11 or 12 in the afternoon. Kobe's there shooting around. Now the rest of the people, rest of the players, are getting to the court to warm up for practice and start practicing. Kobe is already sweating again. So he goes up to Kobe and he says, hey, what time did you go to sleep last night? Kobe says, what do you mean? Since 3 in the morning, he sat and got to sleep, and it was 12 o'clock, and he was getting ready to start practice with everybody. That is the champions that go out there and win world titles. The ones that don't, they do more. In the science of getting rich and thinking growers, they talk about doing more than you're paid to do. In this business, you need to be willing to work without pay in order to get paid without work. Straight up. Remember? Work, 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 check. And eventually, it trims down. Work, 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 check. Work, work, check. Then work, check, then check, work. Damn. Getting paid more than I'm working. Right here it starts going, work, check. I mean, work, check. Then it starts going, check, work. Then before you know it, you're like, check. Vacation. check. New car. Work a little bit. Go do Super Saturday. check. Go to Hawaii to do a presentation for your team in Hawaii. So you take 2 hours to do a presentation, then you enjoy Hawaii. You go scuba diving. And it's a tax write-off. And live like a boss. Yeah, all of those things. So then you start doing all of those things, guys. Why? Because what you're doing is you understood it from the beginning. They told me that, man. I went for like 8 or 9 years without really hardly making that much money. Okay? And they always told me, dude, they said to me like this. This is like one of my mentors told me. He says, network marketing is like a war. And the success lies in being around after the dust settles. And in this war, there's a bunch of dust, smoke everywhere, chaos. People are getting shot. There's going to be casualties. More than, maybe about half this room, 6 months, is not even going to be in this room. Statistics show. Now, this is a group of champions. So I like to believe that this room will have a way higher success rate. Does that make sense? But statistics in the industry show that half of this room in 6 months will be back doing the thing which was the reason why you started doing this business in the first place, a job. Think about it. Most people join because like, my job ain't cutting it, or I don't like my job, or I don't like my boss. That's why they start doing this. And most people end up quitting and going back to that and only that. That's what the statistics show. So he says, network marketing, having success in marketing, is being around after the smoke settles. Then you got all the casualties, all the dead bodies, all the people that quit, and you're still there.
The sifters.
Yep. The sifters. So attend all corporate events. When's the next big event, guys?
Saturday.
October 11th is the next big event. Then we have the Super Saturday, this Saturday. Right?
Spanish.
Right? That's the Spanish one. And then the next big event, because October 11th is considered a big event, guys. Corporate is going to be here. It's going to be packed. I think we're going to have like the number one earners here, right? They're going to be here?
For a while, totally.
Yeah. And then number seven, be here a year from now. That's why it's here, guys. And follow the other six steps. Okay? And be consistent. You got to put your head down for a year. It says here, the dictionary is the only place where success comes before work. The dictionary is the only place where success comes before work. So you got to be here a year from now. If you guys invested $30,000, $50,000, $100,000 in a traditional business, would you give it 3 months?
No.
No. Let me ask you another question. Would you work that business? And you invested $30,000, $100,000, $50,000, whatever you invested. Would you work it harder than you're working your wake up now business?
Yeah.
Real talk. Ask yourself that question. If I put $50,000 into a restaurant, I bet you anything, 99% of you guys would work way harder for that restaurant than you do this business. And you're wondering why you don't have success. And after like a month or two or 3 months, you don't have the results that you want. You're thinking of calling it a day. Throwing in the towel. Do you guys realize what we're talking about here? You got a multi-million dollar business creating millionaires. The industry that creates more millionaires and more six-figure earners than any other industry in the world. And you know why? Because you think it's a $100 business. That's a problem. And I say problem on purpose. Because for most people, it is a problem. Because it's a $100 business and you think. And that's why from the beginning, most people treat it like $100 from the beginning. But if you invested 100 G's of your hard-earned money that you saved up all your life, $100,000, and they gave this opportunity, you paid it. How many phone calls would you make a day?
Yeah.
Straight up. Would you prospect 2 people a day or 200 people a day?
Door knocking, advertising this time.
Exactly. I mean, straight up. How are people in Mexico hitting these ranks? Founder 6, Founder 7, global executive in Mexico. And it's $133 in Mexico. And there's less services and products in Mexico. And people are complaining here. Every single one of you guys by the end of the month should be a founder 3. Minimum.
Yes.
Minimum. No excuse. If you really want it, you go founder 3. Ask for help. Bring people. Talk to people. Be relentless. I think of myself as a juggernaut. You know the definition of a juggernaut? That's what Team VIP is. The definition of a juggernaut is an unstoppable force that meets an immovable object. You know what I mean? So we can't be stopped. And I think of myself like, even like when I used to train more seriously, I used to think of myself in like a kid. I used to think of myself, you know how when we're kids we have an imagination? Like I was a machine. I used to literally think of myself like I was a machine and I couldn't stop training. And I was just like, I would not get tired. That's how I used to be. Of course I did. Of course I did get hurt. But that's how I visualized myself. And that stuff we brought here, and we started having success. When I stopped making excuses, I started finding my results. And somebody told me that it made a lot of sense. Damn, that's true. I just paid $10,000 for this business. I talked to way more people. Because it's my $10,000 on the line, much less, you know. But there's people out there that we know that start a traditional business. You all know start a traditional business. They're going to work that business harder than you're going to work. And they never have a shot, not even a shot, to make more money than you could make in this business. It's like literally impossible for them with their business to make the kind of money that you can make in this business. But you got to go out there and give it a solid year following the business. If you slack off for a week, you got to add a month to your year. Because that's how bad, it's actually worse than that, the momentum. You're building up this momentum, then you stop. Imagine one of those oil wells. I mean, one of those water wells. You guys know the water wells, the ones you're pumping?
Yeah.
Imagine you're pumping it. You got to pump it a gang of times, right? Then the water's going to come out. What if you stop? Let's say you got to pump it 5 more minutes. Then you stop. And you start again in 5 minutes. Is it going to take you 5 minutes to get the water again? Oh, it'll take you way longer than that. Some of you guys are just, you're pumping, you're about to like have a breakthrough, and you stop pushing. Then you come up and you have an excuse. Oh, I'm tired. I'm sick. I don't have a guest. I've been to training before. And guess what? The people that know what's up, they're like, that guy ain't competition. That girl's not competition. They're like, cool. There's no competition. There's no competition. Because nobody's willing to go the extra mile. There's no traffic on the extra mile. You know where there's traffic? Being average and being broke. It's like the 405 at 405. Straight up. Yeah. And here's the thing. People get out of it. They're like, dude, I want to take that route, man. Let me get off because the 405 at 405 sucks. Right? And then they encounter a couple of obstacles. Then they go right back to traffic. You guys ever see traffic in the mornings?
Yeah.
Who sees that? Sometimes I get up, you know, and get on, you know, on the roads in the mornings. I usually don't because I don't like it. It sucks. But I get on and I observe people. And I observe people and they're pissed. Yeah, they're pissed. It's crazy. I look at them and I'm like, they're like they hate life. You know what I'm saying? And they got road rage, a lot of people. And I'm just like, shoot on. I just, like, a lot of times I'm up at that time because I go to the gym and train. I'm looking forward to that. I don't have to go clock in, no, you know what I mean? So they're like trying to cut me out. Hey, it's cool, dog. I don't got to be at the gym at no particular time. It's open all day. I'm straight. You go on and get to your own job. Okay? I'm going to get to the gym. I'm going to work out. Then I'm going to go home. I'm going to shower. Then I'm going to go play with my son.
Wow.
You know why I'm able to do that? Because I was willing to pay the price.
Right.
And I had a gang of people. You can imagine, I had an army of people throughout the years that joined me, friends. And little by little, it's like they get getting shut down. I'm like, damn, you just fell. I thought you were my most solid guy. Damn, that sucks. Boom. Then I'm like, this guy, he's not going to know. I was like, they got birds got him. The Dream Stealers got him. Something got him. A new girlfriend got him. I literally have friends. Got a girlfriend? Look at this. Dude, I've had every story you can. Or girls, got a boyfriend? Got out the business. Or a negative relative, a negative spouse. That's a big thing. You should sign up. You should try to sign up the spouse together. That'll help you out big time. So guys, tomorrow we got the events. You guys know the schedule for the rest of the week. Let's promote Harper for the rest of the week, guys. Let's finish off the month strong. Everybody in this room should be a founder to be by the end of the month. Who in here is ready to make a serious commitment to go founder 3 before the end of the month? Raise your hand. Founder 3. Okay, perfect. Everybody, guys, check this out. Minimum, of course. Some of you guys have a higher rank. So some of you guys are founder 4s and above. So obviously, we're not talking about you, right? We don't want you to go down the line. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'll go founder 3. I'm founder 4. That's easy. Even if I stop working right now, I'll be there.
So here's the thing, guys. Founder 3, if you really want to, you could go out there and recruit the 12 damn people yourself. And guys, don't go Founder 3 on the last day of the month. It's a headache. You should have Founder 3 in the bag by the 20th to the 27th of the month. Get it done. Get it out the way. Buy product if you have to. The products are made. Be a product for the product, guys. So anyways, guys, I'll see you guys tomorrow. And get your tickets from Eddie's for the Super Saturday. Thank you, guys.